Greetings, Joseph Kursky here with you to talk about learning plans and learn paths. You may say, Joseph, what are we going to learn about? GIS, Geographic Information Systems. We all, and I assume you are in this group since you're watching this video, want to learn more about geotechnologies. But remember, it's more than learning how to buffer and overlay and geocode. The goal, the nobler, higher goal, is to build a better, more sustainable, healthier, happier world. That is the ultimate goal. Understanding to make better decisions through GIS. So let's talk about learning plans and learn paths. One of the easiest ways to teach and learn with online GIS tools, data, and activities is with learning plans and learn paths, because they offer a sequenced way of learning specific content and tools. Where are they and how can you use them? Well, first of all, learning plans. A learning plan is a set of resources, readings, hands-on activities, videos, etc., that are sequenced for learning about a particular topic. That's so key, especially with a complex technology like GIS. You can choose plans from a wide variety of topics, scales, and specific ESRI tools. By signing into the ESRI training site, esri.com/training, you can track your own progress through plans. Let's just do that, esri.com/training. You can track your own progress through plans that you have chosen, identify plans that you would like to take in the future, and, especially for you instructors out there, assign plans for your students. Here's a sample learning plan for spatial data science showing the courses, videos, and seminars that comprise it. Now, dozens of learning plans are available. I'm going to highlight a few of them here, and you can start browsing the catalog for others. Filter by format based on your own needs and interests. Here's one called ArcGIS Fundamentals. And this is an example of a plan. You've got a sequence set of stuff to do. What do I mean by stuff? I mean, you've got a tutorial, you've got a web course, you've got another web course, instructor-led. You've got a whole set of things in here in this learning plan. Here's one called ArcGIS Online Fundamentals. And as you can see, you've got a sequence set of things that you actually can do hands-on to cement your learning. Fundamentals of Mapping and Visualization. How do you design your maps with communication in mind? Recommended learning plans for select topics. How about ArcGIS technology for spatial data science? How do you integrate this whole emerging field of data science into geotechnologies? Image classification using ArcGIS. In other words, integrating remotely sensed imagery into your spatial analysis. Let's talk about learn paths. That was an exciting, I hope, journey into learning plans. Now let's talk about learn paths. A learn path is a set of resources, readings, hands-on activities, videos, etc., from the ESRI Learn ArcGIS collection. It's sequenced for learning about a specific topic. You can choose from among many tools and topics, each of which features learn lessons that have been created by instructors at ESRI and also instructors at universities. Each path and lesson is kept current with the latest tools and data sets. To discover learn paths, go ahead and let's take a look through the Learn ArcGIS gallery. Here are the paths. Notice I've selected path on the left side so you can see it's Python, survey 1, 2, 3 out in the field collecting data, the experience builder, CTE programs, Python, lots of stuff in here, but it's all sequenced, which is a great way of learning things, especially a complex, rapidly evolving tool such as geospatial technologies. And you can browse the collection for others. Let's talk about a couple of these here. Getting started with maps and data in ArcGIS Online. This is a great example of a learn path. So you have a 5-minute story map that you examine, as you can see here in each one of these, and you move forward. Trying ArcGIS Pro. Okay, so here is another path, a bit more involved, but again, doable. In a sequenced way, you're gaining skills, you're building on what you've learned in the previous component of the path. Recommended learn paths for selected topics. How about this one? GIS in the Age of Community Health, very relevant to our times, right, folks? You start with the John Snow 1854 cholera map, you look at E. coli, you talk about healthcare costs, malaria, and other things in this path. For geospatial analysts, a learn path. I want to analyze data. That's why I got into GIS, Joseph. Okay, here's one for you. And again, this is just a subset of the many paths that are out there. And finally, solving problems with GIS and public domain data. How do I know what data is out there? How do I use it? How do I know if it's any good? This is rather near and dear to my heart because I actually created this one. Actually, there's three paths in this sequence where you read a chapter from the GIS and public domain data book that Jill Clark and I wrote. Then you go into a lesson, you read another chapter, you go into another lesson, and so on. So that is a learned path about really grappling with data, all about data. So that is a summary of learning plans and learn paths. I encourage you to take advantage of these resources, build your own as well, share them with your students, use them to assign items to your students. And again, the goal is to increase understanding about these specific GIS tools so that you are actually making smarter decisions by using spatial thinking and applied geospatial technology. Remember, keep focused on this tool. This is the most important tool of all, your brain. So keep on nurturing that brain with these paths and plans. Thanks.